Is this thing on?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, so I was actually supposed to be there with you guys live in person, but with everything going on, obviously I couldn't make it out there. But I have a nice video to share with you guys, so here we go. Hello, everyone. My name is Sophie, aka StayGold31 on all my social media platforms. First and foremost, I just want to say congratulations on graduating from International Institute of Cosmetology 2020. I know it's been a crazy year for many of us due to COVID and all the heartbreaks of the world, but never lose hope because life will always have its ups and downs, and you really got to keep moving forward on as best as you can. Last year, I had the opportunity to work with Martin and Tina at the Academy, and I have such high regard and respect for the space they have created for all of you. It's hard to find individuals who truly care about their students and the quality of education that they provide into your training. From spending some time there, I knew that you guys were in the best hands. A little bit about myself. I actually graduated around this time 11 years ago at a cosmetology school in my hometown of Orange County, California. It wasn't the easiest because I was battling a fight to pursue a creative career versus a traditional route that my family wanted, which was law or medical. I was at a weird fork in the road around my second year of college and decided to go into hair. I lost support from my family, but there was something about this that I really wanted to try. I didn't know anything about it prior, so I get through it, get my license, and I was like, okay, so now what? Finding a salon was my next mission. I looked everywhere with no portfolio of work, but just my willingness to try my best. I ended up at a couple places and was moving around quite a bit my first year. I realized that women's color and long hair was just not something I looked forward to. Before I switched careers completely, I now hear about barbershops, which wasn't something I was exposed to before. I was like, okay, I like doing shortcuts, so let me try this barbershop thing before I give it up and switch to a whole nother field. The crazy thing about this was that back in beauty school, I was already drifting towards short hair without even knowing that that's what I enjoyed most. I remember all my classmates in beauty school would see the short clipper cuts coming through and they would all look for me and say, give it to Sophie, give it to Sophie. I started doing all of them. I didn't think anything of it at the time, I just did it. The whole time that I'm learning this new trade, I'm not thinking about anything other than what was in front of me and how I was gonna get better at it. So up next, I eventually found myself working in a barbershop. I quickly realized that it was super male dominated and I just remember feeling so intimidated. I went from working in a salon with all women to the complete opposite. The questions I asked myself was, what do I talk about? Do I bring up sports, but I also don't keep up with it? Am I asking too many questions during the consultation? Am I even good enough to take these new clients? The list goes on because it's normal that we all go through that. Jumping into a barbershop, it was sink or swim. Was I the first draw in the shop? No. Would clients skip over me to a guy first? Yes. In those kind of moments, I remembered asking myself, is this the way I want them to always feel? Not really. I wanted to prove to myself and to them that I was just as capable as the guys. I knew I had a lot to learn, and that's what I did. I learned the value of what hard work actually meant for the first time in my life. It wasn't that we show up every day for our shift, clocking in and out 5 days a week. It was also everything else in between. I was calling up close friends and family and asking them to let me try and practice on them different things whenever I had free time. I was watching tutorials on YouTube and cutting along with the videos. And at the time, there was probably like 3 to 5 videos versus what we have now. I was literally obsessed with getting really good at it. I wanted those guys to see me in the shop the same way that they saw my guy coworkers. Now here's also something else to remember besides the stereotypes of what female barbers go through. Is that guys deal with it too. For example, if an Asian client came in and wanted a cut, he would instantly look for an Asian barber to cut it. It would happen with every ethnicity as they came in. At the time, I had a crazy looking fauxhawk and all the conservative clients questioned because they thought I would give them something crazy other than the simple things that they wanted. I also learned mostly from failure. I learned from giving people the wrong cut, getting bad Yelp reviews, taking too long on a cut, messing up fades and tapers. I've even cried to my coworkers when people skipped over me because I was a female. I was like, why is this happening to me? I'm working so many hours to get better at this and they're just not gonna give me a chance. You know what though? It's all part of the process. There's no way anyone gets into this craft without messing up an entire line of people. What matters most is that we learn from those experiences and we make it better the next time. you also have to remember that we all learn at different speeds. Give yourself care, time, and patience to learn what you love to do. One of the biggest lessons I've learned through doing hair was finding out how passion arrives at your door. First, it's not something that falls into your lap out of the sky. I learned that passion was formed from daily habits. I developed a passion for barbering because what excites me was serving my clients and my community. The smile on their faces when I had hand in that mirror. I loved it so much that 12-hour shifts eventually flew by like nothing. Sometimes we're trying to figure out what we love doing. And how do you find out exactly what that is to tap into everything first. I started off with women's hair cutting, women's styling, color, and then it led me into barbering, then working in a super fast-paced shop, a high-end barbershop, to a men's salon, all to find out what type of clientele or type of work served me best. Explore all your options. The worst thing that can happen is that you cancel out things that you don't enjoy. You're always going to be learning regardless. You have to look for those things or you'll feel hopeless. There's always a lesson in every situation that you're gonna be in. You are far more creative and happier when you're tapped in doing what you love. The beautiful thing about the hair industry is that there's so many avenues. More is available now than ever before. A few years later, I worked so hard that I started getting industry awards for being a barber. I remember it like it was yesterday because it took the biggest weight off my shoulders to be recognized finally for all the hard work that I've been doing. It inspired me to push even harder. Shortly a few years later, I had the opportunity to travel the world and do education, get a brand sponsorship with Babyliss, have my own clipper trimmer colorway edition, now a product launch with Statement. It's teaching me more and more that so much is out there for us. Opportunity is there for the ones willing to be the bravest and the ones that truly can believe in themselves no matter the cards that they've been dealt. The universe is always going to test us and give us situations to make us figure out if we actually do care. And when we do care, we work harder than when we don't believe in it. If I can do this, I believe that many can as well. Visualize where you want to be and don't ever stop until you are proud. So now you guys are here and you're wondering the same question I asked myself 11 years ago. What now? Where do I work? With COVID happening, there's nobody to cut. How do I get hired if I have no work to show? Am I going to be financially stable? I'm a firm believer that we get out of life the more we put in. Time is all we have, and what we do with it is the result that you will receive. You are what you do. If you are constantly cutting hair every day, you're damn right you're going to be good at it. If you do color all day, testing out formulas, shoot, you could be the best colors in your county, statewide, or even the best in the country. It happens. Some of the best people I know all started at zero the same exact way we all do. We can't forget that. Don't ever believe that you are not good enough. It's just a matter of time and more practice. Life itself is one big practice. We are learning every single day. As much as I do men's cuts, I'm still learning every single day. My effort from the beginning till now is still the same. The only way you'll grow is that you have to constantly look for ways to improve everything that you do. I'm literally thrilled that I had this opportunity to share this with you, and I wish someone told me these things when I finished because I was so lost. One very important thing you must know now is to not let social media tell you what you need to be doing. This is something you guys are going through that I didn't have back then. You'll see so much, but view it more as a way of feeling inspired of where you can take it. Our life and happiness is defined by each person differently. Don't ever feel pressure to have to reach a certain level at a certain time just because of what you see online. People's chapter 20 looks a lot different than your chapter 1. I'll say it again, but give yourself time and patience to learn, and most importantly, have fun with it. The way we feel about the things we do is 80% mental. If we don't get excited for the things that we're about to embark on, the journey feels long and frustrating versus a fun learning process. It's also never too late to get into the craft. It's actually the best time. Right now, the most tools are available for you. People have more access than ever before. Utilize what's out there and just have fun learning. This industry has given me so much purpose and so much to look forward to. I'm excited for all of you to go out into the world and find yourselves come to life, learning about who you are, developing your artistry, and finding your true purpose in this industry. Be a sponge because everyone you meet can always teach you something. I wish you the very best on your journey, and I hope you all become very successful and great people and future leaders for the next group. Some last words of advice I want to leave you with to think about. Whatever it is that you are learning, be in that moment. Absorb that entire experience because this is how we stay invested in the things we choose to do. Keep an open mind, be teachable, collaborate with your classmates, consistently create and hair because motivation always follows action. You'll also stay more inspired by the work that you do. Also, don't be afraid to document your journey on social media. Don't doubt that you aren't good enough. Share it, own it, and grow from it. Thank you guys again for having me. I'm honored to be part of this process with you all. Congratulations, class of 2020. Thank you, International Institute of Cosmetology, at Study Hair on Instagram. Looking forward to seeing you all again once the world opens back up. Peace, y'all.